Hey everybody, Reid here. Today I'm going to be playing on MTG Arena with the Simic food deck that I've registered for Mythic Championship number 5. Now, by the time this video is released, I'm sure the Mythic Championship will be in the books and you'll know, if I had a good run or not. But this is a deck that I think is very good in Standard. It's if you're sick and tired of playing the Golos Field of the Dead deck, this is an alternate way to go, making use of some of the best cards. Now, Simic is a pretty obvious deck. I mean, people had this on day one. Oko, of course, is one of the flagship cards from Throne of Eldraine, and this makes use of all the best food mechanic cards, including Gilded Goose and Wicked Wolf. I have this deck labeled Cuneo Simic, after my teammate and legendary deck builder, Andrew Cuneo, who worked the most on ironing out our deck list. And the main thing that we have here is we have 4 copies each in the main deck of Disdainful Stroke and Questing Beast, which are 2 of the best cards for combating those Golos Field of the Dead decks. One thing that you might find interesting about my particular list is I've split my 2-drop creatures. Now, part of this is just I don't really know which is the best. But also there is value in splitting them, since Legion's End is a popular card. You don't want to get caught with multiples of the same 2-drop too often. And then also there are plenty of conditional removal spells available in Standard. Think Disfigure, Cry of the Carnarium, Collision Colossus. And it just makes sideboarding a little bit more difficult on my opponent if they have these removal spells that may or may not be killing my 2-drop creature. But anyway, not that big a deal. You could just play Paradise Druid or Leafkin Druid or whatever configuration of these that you like. Moving to the sideboard, we have the top 8 cards being just pretty obvious color hoser type cards, good against decks of their corresponding color. And then Voracious Hydra is basically the best removal spell that this color combination has access to. It's just a good creature, but it's particularly effective for killing non-combat creatures that are going to be a problem on the opposing side of the battlefield, like Edgewall Innkeeper or something along those lines. And then Lovestruck Beast is very effective defensive measure against the red and black aggressive decks. So I'm going to run the Simic deck through 5 matches on the ladder, and we're going to see what we can do. Also worth noting, we've chosen to play with 4 copies of Once Upon a Time. And what that does is it maximizes the chance of getting your best openings. So for example, the turn 1 Gilded Goose can enable either turn 2 Oko or turn 3 Nissa. And those are your best chances to win, to like score an easy win. You want that to happen as often as possible. Yep, and here you have it. I have turn 1 Gilded Goose on the play. No Planeswalker in this hand, but, you know, having the option to accelerate into either Questing Beast or Wicked Wolf is very exciting. Unfortunately, I don't have a land that produces blue mana, and again, this is a great reason to split your 2-drop creatures. It would be really, really bad to draw multiple Marileaf Pixies when I don't have access to blue mana. And here, on my turn, I'm going to be deciding whether to cash in a food token to play this 2-drop or not. Certainly, if I don't draw anything relevant, then I will do so. I will cash in the food token to play the Pixie. Okay. So, yeah, sure. I guess I just play both my creatures, which the second goose doesn't really do much, but it does produce another food, so I can have 4 mana on turn 3 this way. 5 mana if I draw land. All right, my bones are crushed. Disdainful Stroke, not at its most effective in this matchup, but still maybe I can tag a Torbrand or a Experimental Frenzy. I don't have access to 4 mana, so I think the best thing to do is just pass, and I can make a food token. It would be slightly more appealing to pass on the turn when my opponent's going to hit 4 mana to have the Disdainful Stroke, but, you know, you do what you can. Now, we definitely want to have Wicked Wolf fight the Steamkin before it gets out of hand. And then I even have one food left over to protect against a removal spell or the Fervent Champion attacking. Sure. Kind of interesting turn. My opponent did not have a fourth land, so I don't necessarily need to hold up the Disdainful Stroke unless they draw another mountain and play Torbrand. Can't play a Hydroid Crisis as large as I want it to, so I could be making a food and holding up the Disdainful Stroke. I think it's right to play Questing Beast. But then the question is, what, if anything, do I attack with? I guess just nothing. It's kind of neutral to trade the Questing Beast for the Bonecrusher Giant, but at least leaving it on the battlefield makes it more difficult for any smaller creatures to attack. Okay, more Steamkins. All right, so now I can just play Leafkin Druid, pass with either Disdainful Stroke or making a food, and hopefully a big Hydroid Crisis can put me in good shape before the Steamkin gets out of hand. Like, Leafkin Druid actually producing 2 mana here. I do have Castle Garenbrig to make a 5-5 Crisis pretty easily. Yeah, actually I can make a 6-6 Crisis because Druid and 2 forests activate the castle for 6 mana, 7, 8, including blue. So yeah, 6-6 Crisis, gain 3, draw 3, and then have a creature that can attack over these and is really difficult for red to kill. That should be a somewhat effective plan for winning this game. Sure, I will create a food token. All right, so I have drawn Wicked Wolf, and I can. Oh, I can't hold up Disdainful Stroke. But still, I think I better just get rid of the Steamkin before it gets out of hand. And now I can even start attacking with the existing Wicked Wolf. Wicked Wolf is one of my favorite... I would say Wicked Wolf is my favorite card in this deck. It's just such a powerful sort of Ravenous Chupacabra type effect, but it's also a massive threat and resilient to board sweepers. Having 8 Planeswalkers and 4 Wicked Wolves that survive things like Time Wipe and Realm Cloak Giant is a really, really effective aspect of this deck. All right, so my opponent's just basically going to use this to tap the Wicked Wolf. Probably time to just start bashing with everything. I can kill my opponent in 2 turns this way, and I don't think my opponent is going to be able to deal with me, any kind of relevant amount of damage this turn, especially not through a blocker and a Disdainful Stroke and a food. Yeah, sure. I guess technically my opponent could just block the 2 Wicked Wolves, survive at 1, and then have some kind of crazy experimental frenzy turn. Alright, so I have 10 very powerful cards to bring in the matchup. Even though Disdainful Stroke was kind of decent for me at the end there, I think it comes out because it's a bit clunky. Probably the 4th copy of Nissa can go. Once Upon a Time is pretty important for making sure I have a mana accelerant and then a defensive creature. So I probably want to just keep all of those. And I guess I can trim a bit lower on the Nissas and Crasises. Maybe something like this. I guess Crasis is probably a card that I do want to draw to get myself out of range if I'm sitting behind some big blockers. So I'll keep 3 of those. Yeah, can't complain about this. I have Lovestruck Beast, which is one of the best defensive cards to have in my opening hand, representing a turn 1 and a turn 3 play. And then Once Upon a Time has the potential to even give me something better. Alright, so you gotta start with Once Upon a Time. And yeah, I think Goose looks pretty good here. Though I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna Adventure the Lovestruck Beast and then turn two, I'll go Temple and Goose. And the reason I do this is if my opponent has a burn spell, they have a lot of pressure to use it on the human token because otherwise I can just trade with the Scorch Spitter, take a lot of the wind out of their sails. Okay, so as planned. Honestly, that forest looks fine here because I just have great plays lined up for every turn for the rest of the game. I'm not worried about flooding. And with my opponent mulliganing and missing a land drop, it doesn't look like I need to upgrade to have any kind of super strong plays. Just playing one good card each turn for the rest of the game should be more than enough to comfortably win. Block, Rimrock Knight would be good, but no reason to expect them to have that. Yeah, I'll just get the extra counter on the Hydro rather than playing my tapped land. Now this turn is somewhat interesting also. You could make a case for saving Voracious Hydra for a Torbrand. You could make a case for just playing my Forest and making it a 6-7. But given the Hydroid Crisis in hand, I think I want to prioritize getting a tap land onto the battlefield so that I can play the Crisis for 6 mana next turn. And then given that, I'll just play the Hydra for 2 and fight the Scorch Spitter. This puts me in a better spot if my opponent finds Torbrand or Cavalcade of Calamity. Alright, this is the big turn for my opponent. They gotta make something happen. Feel like having the Aether Gust is gonna be the nail in the coffin, but we'll see. Yeah, this was going to be an interesting turn, if not for drawing the Hydra, but now it's just a massacre. I don't think there's anything like a Hour of Devastation legal in this format. Bonfire of the Damned. Alright, smooth sailing. Welcome back for second match of the day. Had a good showing against Mono Red. I think the creature decks tend to be pretty good matchups for Simic, whereas you have to work a little harder to beat things like Golos and Fires of Invention decks, but that's why we have the Questing Beasts and the Disdainful Strokes. But hopefully we can get a wide cross-section of the metagame represented in today's video. We'll see what my opponent, Skater1357, has brought to the table. Now this hand is okay. I could keep it on the strength of Once Upon a Time and just try to have turn three Questing Beast or Wicked Wolf. So if I don't have a mana accelerant in my top, what, 8 cards between the Scry and the Once Upon a Time, then this hand is pretty bad. I also need to find a land. So, say for the sake of argument that I find a 2-drop off the Once Upon a Time and I need a land in my other 3 shots. 2-drop could also get killed. This is like, I think the bottom of the range of hands that I'm willing to keep. Basically, I would love to see just one more land or cheap card before I would feel good about this. But in general, when you're doing your mulligan decisions, I think you have to have a little bit of faith in Once Upon a Time to find you what you need. One way to think about it is, yeah, I could brick on Once Upon a Time and my Scry and my 2 draw steps, but I could also just mulligan and brick in those 7 cards at, you know, approximately equal rate. Also, for what it's worth, I don't have to cast Once Upon a Time right now. I think it's generally right to do it because, well, for a number of reasons. Gilded Goose is one of them. Also informs my Scry a little bit. I guess I'll just take Forest here. This doesn't look like a matchup where I'm going to need multiple Wicked Wolves, and I do have a very mana-hungry hand. Now, this is interesting. I desperately need a card to play before turn 4, but I think I should just try to play to my next card being a 2-drop accelerant. I don't think this is the type of matchup where turn 3 Oko on the draw is going to be that effective. It looks like my opponent's playing almost definitely a Golos Field of the Dead deck. So it looks like, you know, I may just brick on finding an accelerant in those top 8 cards, but as I said, that could easily happen when I mulligan also.
Who's more foolish? The fool or the fool who believes that? I invite you to change your ways.
Wow. This is not a deck that I'm super familiar with.
It's not
good. Yeah, it looks kind of like my deck, except red for something. Could make a 1-1 Krasis. Does that really do much here? Basically just dead. I am just dead. I guess I have to play a 1-1 Krasis, then chump something, then... Yeah, I think I can just scoop this one. A hand on the draw with no accelerant is just too bad. And my opponent had a good draw, turn 2 Oko on the play. Alright, so I guess I'll sideboard as though this was a mirror. Which, I don't even know exactly how I want to do that. Those seven cards are the strongest considerations. Everything that the stroke counters, Aether Gust also counters, the one exception of possibly Agent of Treachery. But I do think I can trim on those. Questing Beast is one of the weaker cards. All right, let me try this. Yeah, that's keepable. I would like it more if my second temple was an untapped land. So I'm looking to draw a land, a Gilded Goose, or a Once Upon a Time here. Otherwise, it's going to be two games in the mirror where I didn't have a mana accelerant, and that's not a good spot to be in. All right. Oh, no! I overlooked that the castle was going to come into play tapped, which, of course, you know, thinking about it, it's obvious that the castle is going to come into play tapped, but I'm just used to, you know, having a breeding pool out there. Every land in the deck other than Temple of Mystery caused this to enter untapped, so I just had a brain fart moment there. But looks like my opponent did not have a third land to put into play via Arboreal Grazer. And, yeah. Looks like it's going to be basically the same outcome anyway. As last turn I would have played Temple and then this turn Pixie and nothing else. I'm actually going to bottom this. I do think I want to make sure I find a fifth land. Okay, opponent found the land. So now it's going to be Oko.
The brambles of truth twirl and curl, choking out lies. Oh dear.
Yeah, Nissa seems good here. I wish I had a breeding pool so that I could pulled up Aethergust, but I don't.
Through this land, we are all connected. Be wary of the ground you walk on.
You are fouler than a fiend.
I was putting a stop in case my opponent blocked and kept the Oko at five counters. They could do an exchange, and then I would want to make sure to tap the land in response. Unclear if Arena would give me priority to do that, but I just want to be extra safe by setting a stop. I feel like my opponent probably should have blocked with... Well, I guess it's tricky, because if you want to do the exchange, you have to lose two creatures. So maybe it's not worth it. But these matchups are so much about who gets ahead on mana that stealing one of my lands would definitely be a big deal.
You think I'm a crazy beast? Where do you see my mates?
Let's broaden your existence.
Cease this aggression.
That's the sound of a stampede coming straight at ya.
All right. So, think I just want to Wicked Wolf the Goose and then attack Oko with an animated land.
You're too close-minded.
Royal Science.
I do not fear the unknown.
Strike fear into the hearts of the weak.
All right. So Nissa is going to be going down unless I choose to just double chump here. But that's, yeah, not good. So Nissa goes down.
I can help you no longer.
Nothing disgusts me more than law and order.
All right, just kill Royal Scions and pass with Aethergust open, which I can use to get rid of the food if my opponent's going to do something like fight, or I can just, you know, tempo a spell or get rid of the Domri at the end of the turn, something like that. Note that the elk is green, so Aethergust is going to be effective here one way or another.
Oh, have at it, boys.
Sure, so that resolves. opponent can decide how they'd like to attack.
Back after I've licked my wounds.
Yeah, I think I'm fine just playing a Krasis. That's actually the perfect draw because with any luck I can play Nissa, untap the breeding pool, and then have Aether Gust available. I foolishly did not take note of whether my opponent put the questing beast on the top or bottom of their library. I guess they must have bottomed it, right? Because they drew forest.
I'll shear the wool from your eyes and spin you clarity. One bite, and all your cares are gone.
Yep, here's nothing.
Witness the ties that bind us all. The land shall conquer you.
All right, so I'm going to enter full control mode. I'm going to declare these as attackers at Oko. This at the player, and then before blocks, I'll use my 2-mana land to get rid of the elk.
Wallow in your deceit.
And at this point, my opponent doesn't have that much mana, and my board presence advantage is large enough that I think I'll win in a turn or two. But then I'm going to have to get game three when I'm on the draw, which is always a bit tougher.
Plan is crystallizing.
Felt pretty good about my sideboarding. Aether Gust is definitely great, and then Disdainful Stroke less great, and my opponent does seem to have a lot of 3-mana Planeswalkers, which might mean less of things like Nissa, Voracious Hydra, and Hydroid Krasis. Maybe I'll go down to 1 stroke and add back the 4th Voracious Hydra. Sure, this is just a totally normal good hand. Paradise Druid is the best 2-drop to have when on the draw in this matchup because it can't get Wicked Wolfed right away. So I am, if not guaranteed, very, very likely to have turn three Wicked Wolf. Sure, just take Krasis. I guess the way this goes badly is if my opponent does eventually kill the Paradise Druid and I never draw a second green mana, but I think I just want the power.
Quest of mystery.
Royal Scion's probably, I mean, it's really, really good on turn two on the play, of course, but it's probably the least threatening of the Planeswalkers my opponent could have played. Oko, we just know how devastating that is on turn two, particularly fueling Gilded Goose. But the Royal Scion's more of just a draw smoothing type card, and then, you know, what it did is it allowed my opponent to have a really strong play the following turn, but I think I lucked out a little bit that these came in the order that they did. All right, and now Wicked Wolf just has to kill that goose, try to control my opponent's mana a little bit. And then with a little bit of luck, the Wolf and the Nissa can start managing the opposing Planeswalkers. So here my opponent's going to use the trick of targeting an opposing creature and then sacrificing a food to make the Wicked Wolf indestructible in response to the fight. This actually works out probably better for me that it's my Wolf dying and not my Paradise Druid. So I will get to play Nissa this turn, which means pressuring the opposing Planeswalkers at least a tiny bit. And then maybe a big Krasis the following turn.
You will not block our noble path.
Royal Scion, by the way, is ready to ultimate. That's not good. Sure. I targeted the island because my land is probably going to have to chump lock to protect the Nissa. So among many options available to my opponent, they can give a creature plus 2 plus 0 for strike and trample. They can make food token into a 3-3. So yeah, I guess for example, if they made this into a 3-3 and targeted the Wicked Wolf and attacked Nissa with both, it would be guaranteed to kill the Nissa. though. At least I wouldn't have to block with the island under those circumstances.
Loyalty is fickle and fragile.
Yeah, I guess this works too. It's a good play by my opponent. Oh, did they forget to use the Royal Science? That could be costly, leaving me with the Nyssa.
No virtue without bravery.
As tempting as it is to play a Croesus, I think that I want to use the Hydra to kill this Wicked Wolf and then kill the Oko.
I grace you with my lack of presence.
Duels are for push nods. Let's just fight. We are the many.
Strike fear into the hearts of the wicked.
Well, if my opponent attacks with just the wolf, I'm just going to block the Hydra. I would rather lose the Hydra and keep the Nyssa, especially because my end is double Hydra Croesus. So if I lose Nyssa, I can't really cast anything.
Do not test me.
Make that triple Hydra Croesus. Close game. I feel like my opponent's got to be holding something pretty strong.
For the realm.
All right, Nyssa's down this time. I got two extra turns of use out of Nyssa because my opponent, I think, just made an error, like a sequencing error or a misclick, the one turn when they could have used Royal Science and attacked her right away.
Forgive me.
What's that? Something smells rotten. Wait, that might be me.
invert the world to watch kings grovel and worms rule. I invite you to change your ways.
Yeah, can't have the royal science ultimating. So with this attack, if my opponent has nothing, I kill the planeswalker. And even if they have one instant interaction spell, I at least keep it off ultimate. I think two Krasis in my hand is enough. I'll just put that on the bottom. All right.
Oh, there'll be nothing but dust left when I'm done. You call it anarchy. For me, it's just another day.
Fine. Remain blind.
Oh, have at it, boys.
Ooh, the Domri is actually frustrating the voracious Hydra and its ability to kill the island. So I could kill the Gilded Goose. Or I could just make a 6-7. That's not very effective. So I think I'll attack the Royal Science, force a trade here, and then just start playing flying creatures. I wonder if I'm supposed to Hydra the Gilded Goose. I don't think so. That's the one of Disdainful Stroke I left in. Not looking like it's going to be super helpful, as I don't have a great window of time when I can hold mana open. The best draw for me would be Castle Garenbrig.
Ravnica deserves its demise. My plan is crystallizing.
Gust. Well, maybe that'll be effective. I think what I'm going to do is play a Krasis for two. And if I'm fortunate enough to draw a land, then I can have Aether Gust or Disdainful Stroke available. And if I don't draw a land, then my opponent's probably just going to kill the Krasis anyway, if I, like whether I make it a 2-2 or a 3-3. But I got my my what I said was the best draw in the deck. I think I probably drew the two best cards, the most likely cards to get me back in the game. And they would have been better in the opposite order, but I'm not going to complain.
I will learn what nobody yet knows.
So if my opponent casts a spell that I can Disdainful Stroke, like a Questing Beast, Nissa, or Wicked Wolf, I'll pull the trigger on that. Otherwise, I can counter a fight. Let's see. Do I care about Oko entering the battlefield? I mean, I do. Man. Yeah, it's pretty bad for me, but I think I'll let it resolve and I'll use the Aether Gust on Wicked Wolf, which I can then Disdainful Stroke on the way back down. Free.
Oh dear.
I've lived with animals my entire life. Explains a lot, actually.
All right, no blocks. Would you like to go for the kill by sacrificing your food? You would not.
Think up a fun fate for you.
Excuse me, sorry about that. It's a really sick match. Close game. My opponent's actually, under chess clock pressure, which rarely happens when you play arena ladder games.
It's not poisoned. Trust me.
Okay, so I'll probably get to kill one Planeswalker next turn. Still need... I think the... My next draw step is going to have a very, very big impact on who wins or loses this game. Like, if I draw a land, then my opponent still gets to untap with two Planeswalkers, and they have the draw fixing of Royal Science. I can be dead on board if I do this. Like, my opponent chumps one, then animates with Oko. It's going to be a 4-3 plus 2 with the Royal Scions, but, I mean, what am I going to do? Just not kill a Planeswalker? Yeah, I think I'm just not winning if this... I'm not winning if things go badly for me here, so I gotta make a high upside play.
Who's more foolish? The fool. The fool who rules them.
Surely you see the humor here.
Yep, that's gonna do it. Well, it was a sweet match. Challenge. And I'll see you for the next round. Alright, I'm back for match number 3, hoping to rebound after a loss against Team Rare Food. And yeah, that's turn 2 Oko on the play. That's the biggest payoff of this deck, is the maximum chance of turn 2 Oko on the play. I guess not technically maximum chance, you could play Arboreal Grazer if you wanted, but... maximum chance with the cards that I'm willing to play with.
Walk with me, sing with me. I welcome to the feast.
All right, another of the same.
Seems we've encountered another puzzle on our quest. I will learn what nobody yet knows.
Well, I have to imagine it's right to play Questing Beast here. It's a lot of damage to unload, and then I don't get to use Oko to make the food into a creature, but I can just make another food and do that next turn.
I need a hand, Will.
It's not poisoned. Trust me.
My answers lie in the cold truth.
Hmm.
Well, why don't I start by downgrading the Spellbreaker? Oh,
let's broaden your
that doesn't even work. All right, lesson learned. I just wasted my Oko activation. Yeah, that was definitely not a good play. Alright, well, I still get to sit back on either Disdainful Stroke or Gilded Goose activation. And, you know, I didn't really press my advantage there, but I do still have Planeswalker out. So it's not an emergency.
To know is to triumph.
The confusion there was I wanted to change my opponent's 4-4 creature to a 3-3, but of course a really important subtlety with Oko is counters on a creature will still make it larger than 3-3. Oh, man.
Welcome to the feast.
All right, so I attacked that turn because I wanted to free up 3-3 ground creatures as valid attackers for future turns.
Let us plan for the trials ahead.
Alright, so I should have some good options available to me here. Not the least of which is just using Wicked Wolf to make it a 5-5 and kill the Hellkite. So is there any way I can do that and get Nissa onto the battlefield? Okay, so let's say I use one goose and four lands to play Nissa, then I tap for two. No, I don't think I can get the land as an attacker. Alright, my opponent's seen enough. I think what I was going to do there was just leave the Royal Scions at one counter and make sure I held up Disdainful Stroke. Alright, so same matchup as last time, with maybe a couple cards different. But I'm going to sideboard basically the same way. Not totally sure between one and two Disdainful Strokes, but on the draw. Actually, I think I had taken out Questing Beast last time, but it's pretty effective against the number of Planeswalkers my opponent has. Maybe I just want to do like three of a lot of cards. let's try this. A fine hand. If this was a gilded goose, it would be an amazing hand. Oh man, one turn late.
Your new look is enchanting.
Every tale about me is absolute nonsense. Oh dear. Let's broaden your existence.
It's a lot of pressure. So I would have to double. I guess I can block the 2 3-3s. That's fine. Yeah, I'm not thrilled about it, but that's what I'll do.
You fear your truth. Dear.
This is one of the reasons you want to be careful with Uber sideboarding, is this deck has a really high concentration of mana, so you really need that density of powerful cards, the Voracious Hydras, the Hydroid Crisises, the Nissas, and if you have a hand like this where, you know, one of your action cards is an Aether Gust, and you draw a few too many lands, it can be very awkward.
Fine, remain blind. It's not poison. Trust me.
Alright, game three, but this time I get to be on the play. Is there anything I don't like in my deck here? No, it'd just be tweaking and tuning the numbers. I think all the cards are basically pretty good in the matchup. Is basically the dream hand.
Hmm.
shear the wool from your eyes and spin you clean.
Welcome to the feast.
All right. I guess we're going for the beast.
I think a little merriment is in order.
All right. So I played two food beer matches, and I think the person on the play won every game. But I'll take it. I'll see you for round number four. And I'm back for the fourth match of today. I get to win the die roll yet again, and we'll see if Once Upon a Time can find me my Gilded Goose. No. Just a questing beast, so now we'll try to scry into a two-man accelerant. Not having too much luck finding one. I guess Wicked Wolf's probably going to be a strong card against a creature deck, especially after a turn 3 Oko.
About me is absolute nonsense. Welcome to the feast. So it's a game you're interested in.
Okay, so it's going to be Wicked Wolf here, and this deck does have a lot of 1-1 creatures, like the Edgewall Innkeeper and the Foulmire Knight, so I think I should just fight the Order of Midnight and make a second food, and I threaten to block the Lovestruck Beast. There's, of course, the tapping the Wicked Wolf clause, which could come up, but at least I'll force my opponent to spend a removal spell on a creature that's not going to die.
I think a little merriment is in order.
opponents in the tank, see what they come up with.
Blind to your folly.
So the questing beast can't be blocked by the Thalmire Knight. I imagine my opponent's going to block Wicked Wolf. I'm going to sack the food, and then the wolf will be vulnerable. But if my opponent wants to spend a Murderous Rider or an Assassin's Trophy on my wolf, that means they're not killing the Oko. Looks like they're just going to take a big hit after all. Wow, man, that's a tough way to do it. Now my opponent's behind enough on board presence that I can start sitting on Disdainful Stroke to make sure there's no Garrick or Liliana or Fine Finality or something like that.
So it's a game you're interested in.
So I can get rid of two blockers, that's still not enough to have lethal. So yeah, I mean, I'll just attack. My opponent will be forced to block Wicked Wolf. They'll go to three. I'll pass with the Sainful Stroke mana open.
Welcome to the feast.
Do your worst, Mr. Hadouken. All right, so I can just kill the Lovestruck Beast with Wicked Wolf.
I think a little merriment is in order.
And then Questing Beast won't be blocked, and that'll be the last few points of damage. Moving to sideboard. I'm assuming this is an Edgewall Innkeeper deck, so that means all the Voracious Hydras are coming in. Veil of Summer against the black removal, and that's about it. The Aether Gust is okay. It's good against Garrick and Finality, but pretty weak against most of the other things. Yeah, I guess Aether Gust and Disdainful Stroke are both okay, but I don't want to go overboard on them. I think Questing Beast, one of my weaker cards, just trading for Lovestruck Beast is not that effective, and they don't have a lot of Planeswalkers. What else? I mean, I could just try this. And if I was cutting more, I could be shaving Nissa. Once Upon a Time, maybe a two-drop Accelerant, maybe the fourth Krasis, but I think I'm just going to go with this. This hand's just too bad. Nothing to do early. All right, pretty tame opener. If I play Oko, the best I can hope for is that it gets attacked for 4 down to 1, but then my opponent's deck has Questing Beast and Rankle also, so it could just be a disaster. Yeah, I guess I'll just pass and have Once Upon a Time. This is pretty miserable, though. This is when you have no Accelerant on the draw. This Simic deck is pretty ugly. Doesn't have a ton of comeback potential. Oh, I forgot this was free. Usually, this card isn't still free for you by the third turn of the game. But I could have just used it main phase, maybe hit like Paradise Druid or something like that. I guess my best plan might just be like kill the 1/1s and hope the Lovestruck Beasts can't attack. So clearly I should have played the Once Upon a Time for 0 mana. And then, given that I didn't hit an Accelerant, I maybe should have just played Oko as a sacrificial lamb and made a food to keep my life total high. But I don't think I was playing this game anyway without a Accelerant on the draw. So what is Disdainful Stroke counter that Aether Gust doesn't? The answer would be Liliana and Rankle. Maybe that's obscure enough that I want to do 1/1. Sure. This is a case where we're hoping Once Upon a Time finds a land. I could have turn three Nissa. Probably fine to keep on top. Like, it could go badly for me, but I think my way to win this game is to get the Nissa Krasis combo. Yeah. So this is really bad if my opponent has another Legion's End. And medium bad if my opponent has Noxious Grasp. I guess I just gotta let it resolve. The one thing that's really appealing about this Golgari deck is the ability to have four Murderous Rider, four Noxious Grasp after sideboard in this kind of matchup. This certainly looks like a Murderous Rider. Is there anything to be done about that? Wow, I'm shocked that my opponent didn't have Murderous Rider or Noxious Grasp there. Maybe they just have a really bad draw, a bunch of double green cards with no second green. I don't know what's going on. So I was about to fight the Innkeeper, but I wonder if my opponent's way back into this game is Find Finality. I I probably just still win, even if they have that, because of the Nissa. And they could have Murderous Rider or Noxious Grasp into Finality, but it didn't seem like they had Murderous Rider or Noxious Grasp last turn. So I'll just stick with the basic plan of killing the Innkeeper there. Yeah, I don't know what went on with my opponent's draw in that third game there. I felt like they had the tools for a while, but then they just sputtered out. All right, so that has me at 3-1 ranking up, and I'll be back for the fifth and final match of the day. And I'm back for the fifth and final match. Another one of these hands where we're counting on Once Upon a Time to find a Mana Accelerant. And we did it. Goose Oko on the play. There's a clear example of the four Once Upon a Time just maximizing the chances of having the insane draw.
I will invert the world to watch kings grovel. Welcome to the feast.
That's a scary draw. It's a lot of damage output. Opponent's going straight after me in order to get the trigger on Knight of the Ebon Legion, but that's going to be Oko uncontested. And I could even swap the food with the Knight of the Ebon Legion. That seems like a decent play, except that it would mean I can't cast anything this turn. So I'm sure it's better to make a questing beast and a food. Yeah, seems fine.
One bite, and all your cares are gone.
All right. I guess my opponent couldn't answer a questing beast and couldn't attack through it and saw the writing on the wall. Alright, well, my anti-aggro package of the four Voracious Hydras and the three Lovestruck Beasts, and then I guess I can decide about the Aether Gusts and the Veil of Summers, depending on how deep they are into each of those colors. Aether Gust is effective against Embercleave, Veil of Summers effective against Black Removal Spells, Murderous Rider, things like that. I think Disdainful Stroke is clearly worse than either of those. So another case where there's nothing that's really that bad. I think I can go down to like 3 Krasis, 3 Nissa. I mean, Questing Beast was good in that game. Like, it's just hard for Beatdown deck to attack through it. I mean, say I did this, and it's just if they have the Embercleave, they have the Embercleave. That won't do. Generally, Krasis is one of the weaker cards to have in your opening hand. You really want it to be like the 14th card of your library, you know? I actually feel like Leafkin Druid might wind up being the stronger 2-drop in this particular game. Extreme. Seems like Lovestruck Beast might be the card that saves me in this game. Like, you know, I love just blocking here. And if my opponent wants to spend their whole turn trading, that's just great for me.
Magic that dances.
Next turn, I'll have the ultra combo of Castle Garenbrig, Voracious Hydra.
Welcome to the feast. Swallow in your deceit.
Ultra combo activated. The castle just unbelievably crucial here, allowing me to kill off the Spawn of Mayhem. Now I have a ground creature that's bigger than both the Bone Crusher Giant and the Fervent Champion. And yeah, I mean, my opponent, you think they could have waited to see the Oko in my hand, but they just figure if they can't get through the Voracious Hydra, that's that. So all in all, pretty good showing by Simic Food. I went 4-1 in today's session, losing to basically a food mirror where I lost the die roll. But yeah, you can't complain about that. I didn't get to face Golos at all, and that's certainly the boogeyman of the format, but I think it's safe to say that Simic Food has pretty strong game against a wide variety of decks. Hope you enjoyed the video. Remember, you can always subscribe to the Channel Fireball YouTube channel to see more content like this, and I will see you next time.